Team Lethal fans, Mustang King in a house. It's a Monday, but it doesn't suck because we're over at Rare Fab Performance here in Boynton Beach, Florida with our 2021 Bronco four-door first edition. We're doing an install today. We're actually doing the full RPG suspension on here, as well as the all-new coilovers from Eibach. They're fully adjustable and give you up to a 4-inch lift. Since this is a Sasquatch package, it's probably gonna be about 3 inches over factory, but really looking forward to see how it looks. We got those VR Forge wheels on here, which look awesome. So these new shocks or the coilovers gonna give us more travel. It's gonna be awesome for off-roading, and I'm really looking forward to taking this thing for a ride. So let's get on with the install and do it.
So as you can see here, everything on the truck is stock. We're talking stock tie rods, stock upper control arms, stock lower and upper links in the rear. Of course, we also have the stock struts, but we do have a Sasquatch package, but we're gonna be replacing all that now with the RPG and Eibach stuff. Of course, you wanna make sure that you have all the necessary components from RPG before you start this installation progress. They give you a pretty nice list with all of their packages, so you should be able to decipher what you have and what you need. First thing that we're going to do, of course, is assemble all the RPG components. First thing we did is we went ahead and pressed in the spherical bearings into the RPG lower links for the rear. Once you've got that spherical bearing pressed all the way in, you can go ahead and install that last C-clip. Now, it's always a good idea to give the C-clips just a little tap to make sure they're fully seated into their spot so that they don't somehow fall out and therefore become an issue with the spherical bearing possibly being able to get itself out of there. These upper links also need a spherical bearing pressed into them, but they also need the spherical tie rod ends to also be threaded into them. As you can see here, the spherical tie rod ends are a two-piece assembly, so it makes it super easy to adjust it while it's still installed on the vehicle. Now that we've got the entire full RPG rear assembled, we can go ahead and start with the disassembly of the stock stuff and install the new stuff. Now, you don't have to take the gas tank out of the Bronco, although we decided to do so simply for making the video a ton easier on you guys to watch it. Although Ford makes it super easy to get the gas tank out, so it was no struggle at the end of the day. RPG does supply a brand new grade 8 bolt to replace the one that this gas tank blocks on the vehicle, so you can go ahead and cut it without any worries that you won't be able to replace it, since as you can see, this is the problem you run into. The bolt is completely blocked by the guard, and then of course the gas tank itself that's right there. We went ahead and did the lower link first, so we went ahead and cracked that loose with a breaker bar and then finished it off with a ratchet. Same thing with the top. Once it's loose, it'll slide right on out, and then once you have both out, the bar should fall right out of place as it's only held in by those two bolts. Once you have that OEM link out, you can go ahead and slap in the new RPG link. Now, based on RPG's diagram, this is how they want you to assemble the front half of the link. As you can see there, we have the widest possible spacers, one on each side, along with the O-ring there that's going to prevent any dust, dirt, or any debris from getting into those bearings. For the rear, you can see which spacers we use there. Now up to the upper links. Same concept with the bottom, just two bolts that holds it in. Once you get them broken loose, you can go ahead and get it out with a ratchet. Once you get that last bolt out there, boom, it's out of the truck. Now with the new RPG link, you want to make sure that the two bolts that clamp down the actual link itself are facing outward toward the shock, regardless of which side you're putting on. Similar to the lower link, the upper link also uses those wide diameter spacers with the O-ring on either side. And do take note of what spacers we used here. Once you've got this side completely tightened and torqued down, you can go ahead and move on to the opposite side and repeat the same steps. Once we finished up the RPG stuff on the other side of the rear end, we went ahead and started with the Eibach coilover kit. Once you have that bolt out, the coilover should be completely free on the bottom. Now to move on to the top hardware of the coilover. Of course, you are going to have to remove the fender liner to get full access to these nuts. Once you start to get those three studs loose, be careful, because at that point, once the last one is off, the strut should fall right out of the truck. Now you can start to get your Eibach coilover in. Once again, make sure that you take note of the spacers here that go in the bottom mount of the coilover that Eibach provides. They're crucial to make sure that the mounts on the truck correctly capture the bottom of the coilover. Once you've got it aligned in with the bottom mount, you can go ahead and finish at the top mount. Once you got the bolt in for the bottom mount, you can go ahead and tighten down the top mount. Once that's all together, you can go ahead and put your fender liner back in as you're all done with the rear. Of course, now you're gonna go ahead and repeat the same on the other side, of course, starting with that fender liner. At this point now, we decided to go ahead and reinstall the gas tank, although of course, if you didn't do that, don't worry about this part. Now that we're done with the rear, we can go ahead and move on to the front. First thing we're gonna go ahead and tackle is the tie rods. First thing we did, of course, was take off the nut, and now we're gonna try to tap our tie rod out of place. Once you get the tie rod loose from the spindle, you can go ahead and start to disassemble it from the inner tie rod link. You may wanna make sure to count how many times it's actually threaded on, just so that you can reassemble it on the table and match it up with the brand new RPG tie rod. To get the inner tie rod out, you're gonna have to cut the clamp that's on the boot, and then of course you're going to want to take a large crescent wrench to loosen the inner tie rod from the steering rack. Once you've broken your inner tie rod loose, you should be able to spin it out from the threads. Now that you've got everything off the truck, you can go ahead and reassemble your OEM tie rod and compare it up to your RPG tie rod. Make the adjustments to your RPG tie rod to closely resemble the OE tie rod as much as possible, just to give yourself a basis when you do the alignment. Mount the RPG mount onto the car's steering rack. Now, of course, you can finish assembling the rest of the tie rod, but you don't want to install it on the spindle just quite yet, because we're going to be disassembling the spindle to get the strut out. Now we went ahead and moved on to disassembling the spindle so that we could take out the strut as well as the upper control arm to replace it with the RPG and Eibach stuff. First thing we went ahead and did is remove the brake caliper to make sure that we didn't pinch or pull any brake lines or ABS lines. We also removed the sway bar link and pushed it up out of the way to ensure that we have plenty of motion in the lower control arm. While we're down here, we went ahead and loosened up the bottom shock bolts. Next, we went ahead and loosened the nut from the upper control arm, and then went ahead and gave it a little tap to free it from the spindle. The ball joint is somewhat pressed into there from the factory. This is why you have to give it a little tap to loosen it from the spindle. Now, to help give us a little bit more room and motion out of the lower control arm, we went ahead and took off the axle nut and slid the axle just so much out of the spindle. This helps give the lower control arm just enough motion to get the strut out. Once you've got the nuts loosened on the top of the OE strut, you can go ahead and pull it out of the vehicle. Now that you have your OE coilover out, this is the perfect time to take out your upper control arm. Using a 21 millimeter and a 24 millimeter socket or wrench, you should be able to loosen and remove the bolts holding the upper control arm to the frame of the truck. The RPG control arm does require a bearing to be pressed in, similar to the rear links that we've already done. Also, the arm has spherical end links that need to be threaded in as well. Once assembled, you can install it on the vehicle using the OE bolt that you just took out. Once installed, you can get your Eibach coilover installed with the supplied hardware from the Eibach kit. Now, it's just the process of reassembling everything like you had it from stock. If you haven't done the other side of the truck yet, it's crucial that you leave the sway bar link off of the spindle of the side that you just completed. Once you've got your spindle all back together with the RPG components and everything is tightened up, you can go ahead and put the wheels back on the truck and get it on the ground. Next thing you're going to want to do is start adjusting the coilovers to where they're all sitting even on the truck. Now this is of course optional and a bit conditional considering how you have your coilover set up. If you have them maxed out in all four corners, then you're good to go. There's really no adjusting that you can really do. Once you have your truck on the ground, give it a couple feet, move it around a little bit just so that all the suspension can kind of settle into its normal resting spot. To give ourselves a rough estimate on how much we needed to adjust each coilover, we went ahead and measured the height of the truck from the ground all the way to the start of the fender flare on each corner. Coilover height is super easy to adjust with the spanner wrench that Eibach provides. While you can't adjust the coilover on the ground, it is definitely recommended to lift the truck up just to make spinning that coil perch a whole ton easier with the spanner wrench that Eibach provides. Once you've got your coilovers in the preferred position, you're ready to go on to the alignment. Once you're done with the alignment, you're done with the install. All right, so for those of you guys who might be a little intimidated with the installation, if you watched the video, it really isn't that difficult of an install. Rarefab did an awesome job on it. After the install was done, we took it for an alignment. The truck drives great, very straight, no steering wheel being crooked or anything like that, and the truck drives really nice. Now, I'll mention it's a little bit stiffer than the factory suspension was. That's probably due to the bushings that the RPG uses on some of the control arms, as well as a different coilover setup that came on it from the factory. Now, I was able to take this thing off-roading this weekend, and it handled awesome. It felt really nice in both the mud and the sand. I think you guys will really like it. So if you guys have any questions regarding any of RPG suspension products or Eibach coilover kit, feel free to reach out to us at 561-753-8105. And if you like the video, please make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you guys very much.